The Gilgit manuscript are among the oldest manuscripts in the world and the oldest manuscript collection writing in India, which was discovered in 1931 in Gilgit, Kargabudda.
We are here in the historical Yashwani Park, which has been recently converted into a park by the provincial government of Gilgit-Baltistan. From Gilgit, it takes some minutes to reach this point, with the distance of some kilometers in the western part of Gilgit. To reaching this area, you can see that the roads are not very metalled, and you have to come with any sort of bike or vehicle. This place is very famous for the tourist and especially for the Buddhist people, which realize the Buddhist holy books have been found in this place. In 1931, a shepherd recovered some tales of the books and pages in this area. You can see behind me, there are many rock areas which are digged already, and there they have discovered number of tales of books and pages. They were consisted of the Buddhist holy books and holy messages. It is been told that these manuscripts of Buddhist holy pages and holy books are considered to be the oldest writing styles of the world. These writing styles are written in Shina language of Gilgit-Baltistan. All the tales of books and pages discovered and found in this place have been taken to Indian government and a government of Jammu Kashmir, India. It is still stated that the second tall of books were received and recovered in this area in 1938, while the third tall of books recovered from this area in 1956.
This manuscript collection contains such Buddhist work which helped in the evolution of Sanskrit, Chinese, Korean, Japanese, Tibetan religio-philosophical literature, which must have been written between the 5th and 6th century after death.
The face of the image is broad and squarish, with the distended ears, flat nose, broad mouth, compressed lips, range in skull tight, the right hand raised in Abhaya Mudra, a fearless pose. At first look, it seems a naked female figure. However, it looks draped though concentrated vision. According to noted Japanese scholar Dr. Haruko Tsuchiya, this is chamber style figure. The only and another figure of the same style is found in Mulbe, Ladakh. This sort of figure is known as Bodhisattva Maitreya, which is nothing to do with Gandhara art. As per local tradition, it is called Yashwani, which means a female demon degener, evil spirit. A former British political agent, D.L.R. Lunier, stationed at Gilgit from 1920 to 1924, had collected and published this Yashwani tale in his book Gilgit, Chatral and Yasin for the interest of visitors and general readers. That in early times was a Dev woman called the Yashwani. If two men went off from Gilgit to fetch wood, they say she used to eat one and left one go. If our men went off, she would eat two and let two go. In this way, she had eaten and finished off all the people of the countryside. The people took counsel among themselves, saying, how can we kill her, or how shall we bind her? One of them said, in Bagrod there is a Dayal Khamito, he will bind her. When they had the Dayal fetched from Bagrod, he said to them, oh, you folk, this is nothing to worry about. I will bind her for you and give you this advice. After she has been bound, wherever I may go and die, bring my body to this and prepare a grave below the Yashani and bury me there, then she would not come to life again. Thus he counseled the people, and they accepted his advice. The Dayal Kamito, diving iron pegs into the face of the cliff, climbed up and arrived at the door of the Yashani's dwelling. On this, she came out of her house to the door. "O Yashani," said Kamito, "alas, your brother has died in Kashmir." When he said this to Yashani, she pressed her open hand on her breast, and Kamito drew an iron peg into it. Once again he said, "Alas, your father has died in Baltistan." The Yashani compressed her thigh with her other hand, and Kamito drew a peg into her thigh and let it in. The Yashani now was fixed to the spot. She said to Kamito, "What am I to eat?" "Eat gravel of the earth above the basin," said he. After binding the Yashani, Kamito came down again. Then the pupil said, "Now if he go off and dies, or goes off somewhere and does not die, where we are to go and look for him?" Saying this, they slew the wretch Dayal Kamito there and buried him below in this place which he had pointed out. This folktale has been reproduced from the book of the ex-political agent which served Gilgit from 1920 to 1924.
This is a symbolic presentation of Desi mill, flour mill. It has been placed in this Karga Buddha for the cultural and traditional touch. You can see that this is the traditional touch in this historical area of Karga Buddha, which is called as Yashani in local language. You can see this one, which is called Tharingi in local language, Shina language. This is being created after the god killing. If the god is killed, after that from his skin, this is being made, and this is used to make the milk turn into yogurt and other products.